Story Time. Today we have another fun trip that we're going on. But before we do that, how about everybody stand up and we are going to march around like dinosaurs. So get your marching feet ready. We are going to do Lori Berkner's We Are the Dinosaur song.
March.
Great marching, guys. I would like to read you a book now called Paco and the Drum by Matthew Forsythe and read with permission from Simon and Schuster. The biggest mistake Paco's parents ever made was giving her a drum. They had made mistakes before, like the slingshot, that looks fun, and the llama, and the balloon. Woo, there she goes. But the drum was the biggest mistake. Why do you think the drum was a mistake? We shouldn't have given her that drum, said her father. What? Said her mother. The drum is too loud. I can't hear you. The drum was a big mistake, said her father. That sounds like a wonderful idea, said her mother, who still couldn't hear what he was saying. The next day, her father said, Paco, why don't you take your drum outside for a little while? But don't make too much noise. We're just a little frog family that lives in a mushroom, and we don't like drawing attention to ourselves. Paco agreed, and she set out as quietly as she could. It had just rained, and the forest was sparkling like an emerald. And it was very too quiet. Paco started tapping on her drum just to keep herself company. But something stirred behind her. What was it? What do you think it is? A raccoon playing a banjo started following her. So Paco hit her drum harder. And then a rabbit playing a trumpet started following them. But Paco kept playing her drum. And then a wolf, who couldn't really play anything, but was very happy to be near the music, joined in. And Paco was still playing her drum. But then the wolf ate the rabbit. And Paco stopped playing her drum and faced the wolf and said, "No more eating my band members or you're out of the band." "I'm sorry," said the wolf. And he meant it. And then they all started playing again. And soon there was a crowd of animals playing instruments. Look at them all. We've got xylophones, ukuleles, trumpets, all kinds of stuff. And a crowd of animals following them around, enjoying the music. And they were all following Paco. "Paco, your dinner's ready," shouted her father. No one answered. But he could hear music in the distance. And the music grew louder. And louder. Until the crowd swept through the house and carried Paco's parents off into the woods. "Oh no," said her father. "Oh dear," said her mother. "I think that's Paco down in front," said her father. "And you know what?" "What?" said her mother, who was just getting to the best part of her book. "I think she's pretty good," said her father. And no one could hear what he was saying. But if they could, they all would have agreed. The end. All right, are you ready for our next big adventure? Today we are going somewhere we haven't gone before. We have been north. We have been south. We've been west. And we've been east. Today we are going smack in the middle of the United States to Wichita, Kansas. If you took the whole United States and went exactly in the middle, you would land in Kansas. Wichita is about 857 miles away from Grand Rapids. So how long do you think it would take to drive there? If we started right now and drove to Kansas, how long would it take? It would take 12 hours and 45 minutes. Did anybody guess that? So if we left right now, we'd get there around midnight. So it would be the whole rest of the day, we'd get there at midnight. All right, we are going to visit an Air Force base in Wichita, Kansas with some of our librarian friends there. Are you ready? Here we go.
Becca, I'm from McConnell Air Force Base Library in Wichita, Kansas. We are going to read Papa's Backpack. This was written by James Christopher Carroll, and we have permission from Sleeping Bear Press. My papa is a soldier with arms strong and warm. My papa is a soldier, and sometimes soldiers go away for a while, to help for a while, so I can stay and play. But if I could, I'd ride in Papa's backpack and whisper in his ear. I'd ride with Papa side by side, so when he goes, I'm near. Mother, father, daughter, son, sister, brother. Me and my papa, 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 pa. Me and my papa, 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 pa. We'd smell the smoke. We'd hear the growls, the rumble and the roar. We'd feel the sting, the twisted wind. We'd taste the angry rain. But side by side, we'd ride the storm, and side by side, we'd find our way. He'd hold my hand, he'd touch my hair, he'd kiss my face and eyes. Me and my papa, 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 pa. Me and my papa, 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 pa. My papa is a soldier with arms strong and warm. My papa is a soldier, and sometimes soldiers go away for a while to help for a while so I can stay and play. But if I could, I'd ride in Papa's backpack and whisper in his ear. I'd ride with Papa side by side, so when he goes, I'm near. The end.
Join us now in singing You're a Grand Old Flag, written by George M. Cohen, produced by Makowski Music, and enjoy the pictures from in and around McConnell Air Force Base.
This is Gretchen. I'm from McConnell Air Force Base Library in Wichita, Kansas, and we are going to read a Kansas story time now, and we've changed locations. We're no longer on the Air Force Base. We are now at our little city zoo. It was our original zoo. It was called the Wichita Zoo, and now it's all native wildlife. As you can see, we've got critters inside, and then we'll show some pictures later of some of our animals out and about and exploring their habitats. So today we're going to read Love Is All Around Kansas, written by Wendy Solana, and Sourcebooks Jabberwocky has given permission for online virtual reading. Love is a feeling that comes from inside. Everyone feels it. It can't be denied. But how do we know when that it's there? What's the clue? How do we see it? Just what can we do? Love's all around if you pay attention in people and places too many to mention. Go look at the park, on the street, at the mall. You'll see love is all over. It's big and it's small. All around Kansas, in cars and on trains, in taxis and buses, on boats and on planes, in Shawnee and Lawrence and Wichita too, You'll find that there's love that will come into view, and that they're on the Kaw River, and there's our state capital. Right there on the lawn in Antioch Park is a mom and her babe hearing songs of a lark. She swallows him, cuddles him, kisses his ear. And that surely is love. It's perfectly clear. At a store in Lenexa, a girl gets a bear. She squeezes him, squishes him, ruffles his hair. It's clear that she loves him. She's smiling and bright. She tucks him in softly and gently at night. That same little girl the very next day sees a friend at her school who's too sad to play. So she sits down beside him and listens and shares, making sure that he knows that someone cares. Now the boy who was sad feels so much better, as you can see, as he runs home to play, all happy with Maggie. They romp and they frolic, they fetch and they run. It's certain he loves them. They're having so fun. Such fun, sorry. You can see how love travels when shared with a friend. If everyone shares love, it will never end. From one to another, it spreads and it grows. You can't have too much, as everyone knows. An officer in Topeka who helps change a flat. A fireman in Leawood who rescues a cat. The home team that makes the crowd cheer and clap. Each moment has love, and like a gift you unwrap. There's a father who sits at the table each night, helping out with the homework to get it just right. He's tired and busy, but that's love, you know. Giving up what you want to help someone else grow. It's not only people who show love, it's true. Just come see the creatures that play at the zoo. The polar bear tumbles and rolls with her cub. And when they're finished, she gives him a rub. Where else is there love? Have we looked all around? I think we've forgotten. Love grows from the ground. In the meadows and gardens and parks, you will find that earth shows us love in all shapes and all kinds. Wherever you look, love comes into sight. It's there in the morning, it's there at night. But the whole state of Kansas, the best love you'll find is a love that is gentle and selfless and kind. It's the love found at home that shows up each day in things that people do and in things people say. There's no greater love, I can tell you it's true, than the love of your family. Especially for you. Thank you.
Now we're going to sing Home on the Range, which is a Claston Western folk song, sometimes called the unofficial anthem of the American West. The lyrics were originally written by Dr. Brewster M. Higley of Smith County, Kansas. In 1947, it became the state song of Kansas. If you know it, sing along.
Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. Home, home on the range, where the deer and the antelope play, where seldom is heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day. How often at night, when the heavens are bright with the light of the glittering stars, I stood there amazed, and I asked as I gazed, does their glory exceed that of ours? Home, home on the range, where the deer heard a discouraging word, and the skies are not cloudy all day.
We hope you enjoyed your vacation story time here with us. From all of us at McConnell Air Force Base Library in Wichita, Kansas, we thank you for watching. See ya.
Thanks for visiting Kansas with us. Let's put a sticker to mark where we have been. Next week is our very last vacation story time for the season, and then we are all done. So join us again next week, Wednesday at 10 a.m. on the KDL Facebook page to find out where our last trip is going to be. See you then.